The Way Home or Face the Fire, the survival plan for all human plus beings. Chapter 8, The Shining Example, the Light of the World. Do not be afraid of those who can kill your body. Fear only those who can kill your soul. On the last day, that is, God and his soldiers, guardian angels. Matthew 10:28 and Luke 12:4-5. Matthew 10:28. And fear not them which kill the body, but are not able to kill the soul, but rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hellfire. Luke 12:4. And I say unto you, my friends, be not afraid of them that kill the body, and after that have no more that they can do. But I will forewarn you whom ye shall fear. Fear him which after he hath killed hath power to cast into hellfire. Yea, I say unto you, fear him. Seek the truth, and you will find it. How can you expect to find the truth when you are not seeking? Luke 11:9-13. And I say unto you, ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For every one that asketh receiveth, and he that seeketh findeth, and to him that knocketh it shall be opened. If a son shall ask bread of any of you that is a father, will he give him a stone? Or if he ask a fish, will he for a fish give him a serpent? Or if he shall ask an egg, will he offer him a scorpion? If ye then, being evil, know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more shall your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to them that ask him? Seek the truth, and you will find it. How can you expect to find the truth when you are not seeking, and are wasting your time watching soap operas and sport on television, or are looking in the wrong places, that is, organized religion? Jesus told you everything that you need to know, including that if you earned your right to go home, you would be angels again. Matthew 22:30, Luke 20:34-36, and John 10:34. Matthew 22:30. For in the resurrection they neither marry nor are given in marriage, but are as the angels of God in heaven. Luke 20:34. And Jesus answering said unto them, the children of this world marry, and are given in marriage, but they which shall be accounted worthy to obtain that world, and the resurrection from the dead, neither marry, nor are given in marriage. Neither can they die any more, for they are equal unto the angels, and are the children of God, being the children of the resurrection, resurrection, resure of who is right, God. John 10:34. Jesus answered them, is it not written in your law, I said, ye are gods? And about reincarnation, Luke 20:38 and John 9:2. Luke 20:38. For he is not a God of the dead, but of the living, for all live unto him. John 9:2. And his disciples asked him, saying, Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? Jesus answered, neither hath this man sinned, nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest in him. He said, which planet is heaven? Revelation 2:28 and 22:16, King of Kings Bible, 30:16, King of Kings Bible, Revelation 30:16. And there was great light, and there stood before me the Savior, the Christ. And he spake thus, that I may know the authority of the angel, and bade, watch for the star, that was foretold by the prophet Jacob, that you will know the time of the second coming, when I will enter all hearts. I, Jesus, have sent mine angel to testify unto you these things in the communities. I am the root, source, and successor of David, Ezekiel 21:27, and the bright and morning star, Ezekiel 21:27. I will overturn it, and it shall be no more overturned, until he come, whose right it is, and I will give it him Shiloh, Genesis 49:10. Genesis 49:10. And the scepter shall not depart from Judah to Joseph, nor a lawgiver from between his feet, until Shiloh comes from Joseph, Ephraim, verse 22-24, and unto him shall the gathering of the people be. He said, which planet is heaven? Which was confirming Isaiah 14:12. How you have fallen from heaven, Lucifer, Satan, Iblis, son of the morning star. Isaiah 14:12. How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning star? How art thou cut down to earth, which did weaken the nations? He said, which planet is heaven? Which was confirming Isaiah 14:12. How you are fallen from heaven, Lucifer, Satan, Iblis, son of the morning star. King James Version, which is the authorized version, and the second most accurate, which was confirmed again later by the Quran, Surah 53:49 and 86:1-4. Surah 53:49, that he is the Lord of Sirius, the mighty star. Surah 86:1-4, Tariq, the nightcomer, or the morning star, by the sky and the night visitant therein. And what will explain to thee what the night visitant is? It is the star of piercing brightness, Revelation 30:16. There is no soul but has a protector over it. He told you exactly what you have to do to earn your right to go home. I am the door. No man goes home to God except if he is like me. John 10:7-9. Then said Jesus unto them again, Verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. All that ever came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out, and find pasture. I am the way home, the truth, and the life. John 14:2-6. In my Father's house there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And where I go ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas saith unto him, Lord, we know not where you go, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Not one man cometh unto the Father except by me. Which means, I am the way you have to be. What I am telling you is the truth. And I am the way to eternal life, immortality. Greater love than this has no man, that he lays down his life, human life, for his friends. John 15:13. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his self, life, for his friends. Jesus did it for his enemies, that is, all of you. Luke 9:55. But he turned and rebuked them, and said, Ye know not what kind of spirit ye are of. Cross-reference Revelation 12:7-9 and Matthew 8:22. He that loves his life in this world, and likes being an animal, and collecting worldly treasures and wealth, shall lose his soul, die in the fire on the last day. And he who hates his human life in this world, and doesn't like being an animal, and having worldly wealth, at the expense of others, and who always fights for good, no matter what the cost, shall win his freedom, immortality, and right to go home. John 12:25, Mark 8:34-38, and Surah 16:104-111. John 12:25, He that loveth his life shall lose it, and he that hateth his life in this world shall keep it unto life eternal. Mark 8:34, And when he had called the people unto him with his disciples also, he said unto them, Whosoever will come after me, let him deny his self, and take up his cross, and follow me. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it, but whosoever shall lose his life for my sake and the gospel's, the same shall save it. For what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? For what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? Whosoever, therefore, shall be ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of him shall the Son of Man be ashamed, when he cometh in the glory of his Father with the holy angels. Surah 16:104. Those who believe not in the signs of the I am will not guide them, and theirs will be a grievous penalty. It is those who believe not in the signs of I am that forge falsehood. It is they who lie. And anyone who, after accepting faith in I am, utters unbelief, except under compulsion, his heart remaining firm in faith, but such as open their breasts to unbelief, on them is wrath from I am, and theirs will be a dreadful penalty. This because they love life of this world better than the hereafter, and I am will not guide those who reject faith. Those are they whose hearts, ears, and eyes I am has sealed up, and they take no heed. Without doubt, in the hereafter they will perish. But verily, to those who leave their homes after trials and persecutions, and who thereafter strive and fight for the faith and patiently persevere, thy Lord, after all this, is oft forgiving, most merciful. One day every soul will come up struggling for itself, and every soul will be recompensed fully for its actions, and none will be dealt with unjustly. It is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man, worldly wealth, to go to heaven. Matthew 19:24. And again I say unto you, it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter into the kingdom of God. Do not collect treasures on earth, where moths and rust destroy them, and thieves break in and steal them. Earn treasures in heaven, where they are safe forever, which means earn favor with God by being and doing like Jesus, and thereby earn your pardon and go home to heaven. Why exchange your right to go home to heaven and live forever for all the treasures of this world? Luke 16:19-31. There was a certain rich man, which was clothed in purple and fine linen, and fared sumptuously every day. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, which was laid at his gate, full of sores, and desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores. And it came to pass that the beggar died, and was carried by the angels to Abraham's bosom. And the rich man also died, and was buried. And in hellfire he lifted up his eyes, being in torments, and seeth Abraham afar off, and Lazarus in his bosom. And he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me, and send Lazarus, that he may dip the tip of his finger in water, and cool my tongue, for I am tormented in this flame. But Abraham said, Son, remember you in your lifetime received your good things, and likewise Lazarus, evil things? But now he is comforted, and you are tormented. And besides all this, between us and you, there is a great gulf fixed, so that they which would pass from here to you cannot, neither can they pass to us that would come from there. Then he said, I pray thee therefore, Father, that thou would send him to my father's house. For I have five brothers, that he may testify unto them, lest they come into this place of torment. Abraham said unto him, They have Moses and the prophets, let them hear them. And he said, No, Father Abraham, if one went unto them from the dead, they will repent. And he said unto him, If they will not hear Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded, though one rose from the dead. Why exchange your right to go home to heaven and live forever for all the treasure in this world that you can never keep and certain death? What good will it do you to own the whole world for a few years and pay for it by losing your immortal soul forever? All the money you made will never buy back your soul. Everything in this temporary world is not worth one soul. Luke 12:19-21 and Zephaniah 1:18. Luke 12:19-21. And I will say to my soul, Soul, you have much goods laid up for many years. Take thine ease, eat, drink, and be merry. But God said unto him, You fool, this night your soul shall be required of thee. Then whose shall those things be, which thou hast provided? So is he that layeth up treasure for himself, and is not rich toward God. Zephaniah 1:18. Neither their silver nor their gold will be able to deliver them in the day of the I Am's wrath. But the whole land shall be devoured by fire of his jealousy. For he shall make even a speedy riddance of all of them that dwell in the land.